Assalamu alaikum students, hope you all are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Today we are going to read the chapter 1 of your English literature book, which is on page number 9. So kindly open your book in front of you and listen to me carefully. This chapter is only for reading purpose. Now, I am going to read the chapter, The Secret of Sea View Cottage. "Isn't it wonderful?" cried Jimmy Wright as he followed his comrades of the Castle Patrol into the tiny cottage standing a few yards from the deserted beach. "I wonder if we shall find any treasure buried under the floorboards," he cried. "Mr. Millman, the wealthy scoutmaster of the troop of Sea Scouts, letting your imagination run wild, Jimmy." The youngest member of the patrol went red. "I was just wondering, sir," he said lamely. The scoutmaster patted the boy on the back. "It will be dark soon," he said, "and I am sure you are all as hungry as I am after the voyage." "Yes, sir," cried the scouts, and then began a general forage round for stores and cooking pots. An hour later, the boys turned at page number 11, and the scoutmaster gave went to satisfied sighs and agreed that a meal had never gone down so well. "Do you think this place is haunted, sir?" asked Jimmy after the meal had been cleared away and he listened to the creaking of the floorboards overhead. Mr. Millman nodded, a smile on his lips. "It's local gossip," he answered, "and I well remember that when my brother and I were lads, we used to see all manner of weird shadows pass across the windows of Sea View Cottage." The speaker laughed, "but don't you worry," he added, "you won't meet any ghosts." The youngest scout grinned rather feebly and then, squaring his shoulders, glanced across at his best friend, Bob Willis. "Hey, Bob," he cried, "let's explore." And at the other's eager nod, the two rose and vanished up the winding staircase of the old cottage to which Mr. Millman had brought some of his scouts in his small yacht for a month's holiday. Meanwhile, the others continued to talk, and Gerald Turnbull was in the middle of a rather funny story when there came a terrific clatter on the stairs and Bob Willis literally fell into the room. "Help!" he gasped. Ghosts. We've seen them. Don't be silly, snapped the scoutmaster. Gripping the seal, scout, you are not a kid. Bob swallowed hard and pulled himself together. I am sorry. Turn at page number 12. Sir, he answered bravely. But Jimmy and I saw a figure upstairs and... Where is Jimmy? Asked Jack Barton suddenly. Bob shook his head. I don't know, he replied. I thought he was behind me. Mr. Millman looked rather anxious. Come along, all of you, he said. This must be looked into. And he led the way upstairs to find all the bedrooms deserted. Jimmy Wright had completely and utterly vanished. Suddenly, there came a cry from the room over the kitchen, and as the others dashed back into the room where Bob had seen his supposed ghost, they found Jack Barton peering into a cupboard. Look, sir, cried Jack as he held the door of the cupboard open for his scoutmaster. Isn't that a door or something at the back? Mr. Millman whipped out a torch and flashed its beam on the back of the cupboard. You are right, he muttered. And what's more, it is partly open. There's no doubt that our young friend Jimmy has gone exploring further. Keep together, all of you, and follow me. There seem to be some steps leading downwards. The boys of the Castor Patrol followed eagerly, their hearts beating with excitement and hardly able to credit the fact that they were having a great adventure on the first day of their holiday. One by one, they passed through the cupboard and then down a flight of dirty, worn and slippery stone steps. Once down these steps, the members of the patrol found that they were in a lofty, well-built tunnel. All had torches, for whoever heard of a scout who was not prepared for. Students, move at page number 13. Any emergency? So that these tiny points of light were quite enough to light up the tunnel. The procession moved forward in silence and without any incident. But suddenly, the scoutmaster called a halt and pushing and jostling. The boys managed to get close enough to their leader to see what had caused him to stop so abruptly. Here is the reason for the tunnel, whispered the owner of the yacht, which even then rode safely at anchor in the bay. Here is evidence of what work Bob's or ghost does for a living. Turn at page number 14. Next were crammed forward and questions rose to every pair of lips. Do you mean that we've hit upon a smuggler's lair? Whispered Bob. That's about the size of it, agreed the scoutmaster. And I reckon there's something like 1,000 pounds worth of contraband goods here. Jove, whispered Jack Barton, what a thrill. Then he paused, but what about Jimmy? He went on, if there are smugglers about, even modern ones, won't he be running into terrible danger? The scoutmaster raised his hat. By Jove, he said honestly, you are dead right, Jack. We must push forward at once. Those men won't stop at anything to prevent their secret from being. Mr. Millman stopped speaking as abruptly as if someone had pressed pause. For a sudden shout echoed round the tunnel. Quick, yield Geralt Turnbull. I've found a treasure and a skeleton. In a second, the scoutmaster and the rest of the Castle patrol were dashing along the tunnel. Bob Willis was the first to arrive at his comrade's side, but the others were not far behind. Soon, they were all staring with amazed eyes at a pile of tarnished gold and silver articles, which were hidden in a deep recess in the wall, and at a bleached skeleton. Jumping snakes, cried Mr. Millman, this is a find. This is. Come at page number 15. Why the tunnel was constructed, the smuggling part of the business must have come much later. He paused. But how did the smugglers manage to miss it? I should have thought it would be impossible not to see this lot. Oh, but sir, put in Geralt, it was all hidden by a covering of plaster, which was completely concealed by layers of dirt. It was by sheer accident that I fell heavily against the plaster. The scoutmaster nodded understandingly and, after examining the treasure and avoiding contact with the. Turn at page number 16. Bones. He straightened up. We can't bother about this now, he cried. We've got Jimmy right to think about. Forward the Castle patrol, but make less noise. I think I can see the opening just ahead. And he leveled his torch towards the tunnel some yards away. Shall we turn off our torches? Asked Bob. a good idea, came the reply. And so, in the darkness of that underground tunnel, the members of the patrol of Sea Scouts crept along towards the entrance. It was a weird and solemn experience, and none of the boys were sorry. When they finally emerged into the open air at a quiet spot amongst the sand dunes, some 200 yards from the water's edge. "Now what?" whispered David Jones. "Shh!" hissed the scoutmaster warningly. "I thought I heard something," and the party stood stock still and listened intently. "There's someone close by," whispered Bob Willis in his leader's ear. "To the right, I think." The other nodded, and then, bidding the reminder of the patrol stay where they were, he and Bob wriggled their way forward between the low shrub-like bushes. Bob was leading, and so it was that he was the first to discover his chum. "Jimmy," he cried as he stumbled over the form of the scout who had started the adventure. "Are you all right? Speak, Jimmy. For goodness sake, say something." Come at page number 17. "Oogle, oogle, boom," said Jimmy obediently. "He's gagged," rapped out the scoutmaster as he bent over the prostrate figure of the youngest member of the Kestrels, and in less than a minute, Jimmy Wright was gasping out his story, the gist of which was that he had chased a ghost through the tunnel only to meet with three other very solid ghosts on the beach. "They knocked me on the head," he finished ruefully. "Tied that filthy rag round my mouth until I could hardly breathe. And then pinched the Seahawk. I heard them start the engine." Mr. Millman did not hesitate for a second, and as there was no longer any need for silence, he placed a silver whistle to his lips and blew three short blasts. Call of the Kestrel Patrol. In a very short while, the rest of the scouts came up at the double. "Man the outboard," commanded the scoutmaster, "and make for the yacht. You, Bob," he added, "signal the captain to up anchor. We are going after those smugglers unless," he hesitated, "unless anyone would like to turn in," he finished. A chorus of protest went up, and a few minutes later, the whole patrol was aboard the smaller of the yacht's three shore craft. It was a tight squeeze, for the stolen Seahawk was much the bigger boat, but the Sea Scouts managed it and were soon making. Without lights for the yacht, they had not yet steamed away after bringing the boys to the cottage. Students, come at page number 19. When they arrived alongside, they were greeted by Captain Strutt. "You are too late, sir," he called out, "and it's a good job. I didn't sail on the evening tide, but I'll lower the gangway, sir," he added, "and tell the whole story. Now, what's all this about, Captain?" demanded the owner of the yacht as he finally stood on deck. "What do you mean by saying that we are too late?" The hardy old salt saluted and then grinned almost boyishly. "I mean just this, sir," he answered, and at a sign from him, three sailors came forward, dragging between them four very sorry looking specimens of humanity. "Were you looking for these gentlemen, sir?" he asked. Mr. Millman nodded. "We were," he answered, "and I am mighty glad you saved us the trouble of chasing them. Saw them making off with the Seahawk, sir," said the captain. "So me and the second mate tumbled into the long boat and nabbed him." The scoutmaster looked worried. "What shall we do with them?" he asked. "They probably belong to some village about here." The captain shook his head. "No, sir," he replied. "They are foreigners, and I reckon you gave them a complete surprise when you moved into the cottage. They have probably been doing a roaring trade in smuggled goods for ages." Mused the owner of the yacht. "Then we had better keep them below for tonight and hand them over to the police in the morning." Turn at last page of this chapter, that is 20. And thus, the secret, or rather the two secrets of Seaview Cottage became revealed. And after a good deal of legal talk, the Sea Scouts received a goodly sum of money from the government as their share of the treasure too. Then the big yacht was bought for the troop, for it must be mentioned that Mr. Millman had seriously considered selling it owing to the expense incurred in keeping it in commission. And the scouts had one of the finest vessels of its kind around the coast of Great Britain, all because Jimmy Wright and Bob Willis went chasing ghosts. Oh, and by the way, Seaview Cottage is now known as Smuggler's Cottage and is the smartest little place one could ever wish to see. By Arthur Groom from Our Boys Yearns. Arthur Groom, 1898-1964, wrote over 100 books for children. He also worked as a journalist and lecturer and was enthusiastic about scouting. During the World War II, he was a captain. Now students, as I told you कि ये chapter आपका reading purpose के लिए था, अब आपने इस reading को सुनने के बाद खुद से reading करनी है as much as you can to improve your reading skills. Students, these are the words of chapter The Secret of Sea View Cottage. जिसके डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स हैं मैं इसको रीड करने जा रही हूँ. लिसन टू मी केयरफुली. पेटेड, लेमली, वोयेज, वैनिश्ड, क्लैटर, सॉलोड, क्रीकिंग, ग्रिंड, एंक्शस. Utterly, halt, gasped, snapped, abruptly, jostling, whispered, crammed, reckon, honestly, tarnished. Contraband, concealed. Straightened, solemn, stumbled. Adventure, crept, prostrate, roughly, chorus, hesitate. Tumbled, foreigners, mused, napped, intently, forage, roaring, revealed, incurred, smuggler, retain. So students, ये डिफ़िकल्ट वर्ड्स हैं चैप्टर द सीक्रेट ऑफ सी व्यू कॉटेज के, जिसको आपने अपनी एक्सरसाइज नोटबुक में लिखना है, इसको प्रोनाउंस करना है, इसकी प्रैक्टिस करनी है. एंड दिस पे आपके रीडिंग स्किल्स और राइटिंग स्किल्स इम्प्रूव होंगे.